I'm Bob Lees, I'm the principal of Camp Yountville, serving in my ninth year at DC. Welcome back to our campus. We've done our memorial mass for alumni on the feast, or near the feast of All Souls Day, which was on Saturday. To remember our alums who have passed on, and we're grateful that you're here and in their memory, we pray for them this evening. Just so many of you have not been on campus in a while, we're doing great things here. Our school is full. You see a great art center that's coming up. We've redone the gym. We've redone the religious residence down the administration building. The old administration building is no longer here. So things are really moving in a great, great, and positive direction. We have a wonderful, wonderful student body and more interest in the school than we can even believe. And so we're very, very blessed at this time. So thank you so much for coming back to TC, and we dedicate this evening in prayer to your lost family members. I do want to make one announcement. After, you'll notice the tree over there, Courtney Frisch, our director of alum, has tagged the new leaves for your family members with a red dot, just to make it a little easier for you to find them. So that you'll have time for that afterwards. And we are so, so blessed to have a TC alum and great advocate for our school, Father Tom Morgan from the class of 76, to be our celebrant. So if you would rise at this time, you're welcome, Father Tom.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who will that your only begotten Son, having conquered death, should pass over into the realm of heaven, grant, we pray, to your departed servants who we remember this evening, that with the mortality of this life overcome, they may gaze eternally on you, their Creator and Redeemer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. And I would like to invite you to the Coca-Cola class of 1974 on the Please Come Lord for the first reading.
I read from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and nor torment shall touch them. They seem, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and they're passing away with their thought and affliction, and they're going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stone. They shall judge nations and rule over people, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with the Holy One, and his care is with his elect.
Thanks be to God.
Now, Wife Mackenzie Goldsley, class of 2015. Pray the response to our song.
The response is, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, for you are on my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
Second reading will be read by Matthew Menendez, class of 2003.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me. Because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. This is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Continue to be heard in our halls and in our hearts. John Denver's father died, he wrote a song called On the Wings of a Dream. He says something that I believe we could all identify with. Here's the first part, and I'm going to share the rest of the song. If I sing for my father, and in truth, you must know I would rather he was here by my side. I think we would all say, yes, we really wish. I know there are times that sometimes the suffering that people go through is real and so much that we are happy for our loved ones when they leave us from that sense and are no longer suffering. But we certainly wish they were here with us. And that's why this evening is so important, because we continue to say in our memories, in our love, and in our remembering them on this memorial tree, they are here with us. We could fly on the wings of a dream to a place where the Spirit could find us, and joy and surrender would bind us. We are one anyway. Anyway, we are more than we seem. There are those who lead us, protect us each step of the way, from beginning to end, from each moment, forever, each day. Such a gift has been given, it can never be taken away. Though the body is passing, must leave us, there is one who remains to receive us. There are those in this life who are friends from our heavenly home. So I listen to the voices inside me, for I know they are there just to guide me, and my faith will proclaim it is so. Brothers and sisters, the one who has the last word is the one who is responsible in the first place for us being here and for us being blessed by our beloved deceased, our good and gracious God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. What does he have to say to us? He says it very clearly. I think we just have to give, we really want a glimpse into the God who is. We just need to look into our heart, to look into the love that brought us here tonight. We're here because we love those so much that have left us. And I grew up many years ago, just a few streets down on Bar Drive in Wellsworth. And on my street, Michael McMullen, the McMullens, who were also graduates of Camden Catholic, was there. But there was somebody named Donna Jones. And in front of Donna Jones' house, there was like this, what do you call the boxes where they put the plants, the flower thing, the bobbies, whatever those things are called. But every time little Tommy Morgan sat down on that thing, it must have been cheap paint that her father used. I always would have like powdered paint, something on my pants. But I think that is a good image, brothers and sisters, of what really happens when we allow love to get us close to the reality of who God is. Because when we deeply love somebody, and as I say, when it comes to those that we love, isn't the greatest gift to be with them, to be in their presence? You know, we're on the verge. It's always a sort of a tough time. And I know for those that, you know, we're here because most of you lost somebody in this last year, and the holidays are coming up. But you know, I think we ought to probably learn from our Jewish brothers and sisters, you know, that our beloved deceased are still part of our life. That's why we're here tonight. And then maybe when we have our celebration, whether it be Thanksgiving or Christmas, that we set a place for them, because they're with us. And we miss them, and it might be a little hard to look at that empty place, but we're also celebrating something very important and something very real, their life, their love. I have always taken great comfort in a prayer that is prayed toward the end of a funeral mass. It says this: before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother or our sister. May our farewell express our affection for them. One day we shall greet them again. And as the Gospel of John reminds us, listen to the words of Jesus: your hearts will rejoice with a joy that no one will will be able to take from you. No one will be able to take from you. One day, brothers and sisters, those whom we remember this evening, we will greet them again, and our hearts will rejoice with a joy that no one will take away from us. And at this time, I would like to invite Rhonda Villamia, class of 1972, to come forward for the prayers of the faithful. Please stand. And let us in faith call upon God the Almighty Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Gregory, and all our church leaders, that they may continue to guide us in the path of holiness, living out the virtues of faith, hope, and charity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in the powerful, transforming gift of hope, may it help to heal any sorrow and despair dwelling in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, that we may help and support one another on the journey to God, that we will follow the Lord's way side by side and share joys and sorrows, life and death, in the hope of the resurrection to come. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the sick who have asked us to pray for them, may they feel the healing touch of the Lord upon them, and remember that they are not alone in this redemptive journey. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the deceased members of the Tampa Catholic community, our departed alumni, parents, faculty members, and benefactors, we pray that they rest in the peace of Christ, whom they served in this life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those intentions which we hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the prayers of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be
God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, on the sacrificial offerings we present to you for the souls of your servants. And just as you bestowed on them the dignity of the Christian faith, grant them also its reward through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right. right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember also our brothers and sisters who who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Please stand. Ever-living God, this day revives within us memories of loved ones. You're no longer physically with us. Their memory is a blessing forever. They are no longer with us at Tampa Catholic, yet we still remember and honor them. The links of life are broken, but the links of love and remembrance cannot break. Remember them with gratitude, for they cared for us and taught us and inspired us. Their living memory is a blessing forever. We give you thanks that they now dwell with you, O Lord, in the company of your saints forever. May they surround us with their blessing and encourage our hearts as we carry on that same calling to be persons of faith, excellence, and family. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I regard this, you know, this is a privileged place for us to be here, that sort of in-between place between heaven and earth. And we believe that those that we love are very much part of this moment. They're here, they're united to us. They are connected to us at this moment. And when I went to Tampa Catholic, the tuition was $400. That, back then, seemed to be like a lot of money. But I'm thankful for my parents sacrificing to allow me to come. I always say, my sister was principal at Corpus Christi School in Temple Terrace. We were talking about her before. She would be speaking here at Tampa Catholic. I always say my parents loved me more than they loved my sisters and brothers. So they sent me here. They didn't send them. But I'm so grateful that my parents sent me here to Tampa Catholic. And I'm so thankful and privileged to be with you here this evening to remember those beloved that you come here for to remember. And this is holy ground. And this is a place that, you know, we have been touched and enjoyed the friendship of my classmate and relative who is being remembered here this evening, and to all of your beloved. And we thank God. This will always be a place where, if it's possible for us to, I don't know about anybody else, but I know about me, if it's possible for us to visit, come down from heaven, when I'm gone, you may find me here. So I want you to know that. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying God by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Sandra Dahlberg, class of 1979. Donald Ogleton, class of 1974. Maria Cordy Balzerano, class of 1974. Yvette Perlita, class of 1986. Phyllis Gennaro, class of 1970. David Gale, class of 1983. Natalie Gutowski, class of 2002. Myron Jackson, class of 1972. Laura Carney, class of 1983. Magaya Kimbrough, class of 1995. Anthony Leto, class of 1968. Kay McGunkin, class of 1969. Denise Gonzalez Menendez, class of 1975. Sharon Mallet Oakley, class of 1970. Rebecca Rendon, class of 1969. John Risky Jr., class of 1966. Rebecca Scully, class of 1965. Francis Pandolfo Vasquez, class of 1976. Phyllis Weislow, class of 1972. Patricia Bender, faculty. Rita Fulco, staff. Patricia Landry, staff. And Irma Moscato, coach.
Lord, we call upon you to bless those whose names appear on this sacred tree of life. We recall in a special way our alumni, faculty, and benefactors who died this past year and whose leaves have been added to this tree. May Almighty God bless these leaves. May they be ever a remembrance of the special persons that we remember this evening. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.